Welcome to Refresh. This is Pastor Kim Robinson. It's my desire that you listen, that you could experience blessed faith and creative life with this Kix Ministries and Victory Harvest Church podcast. Hi, this is Pastor Kim with the Refresh podcast. The title of my podcast this week is Truth. With truth is faith. With truth is love. With truth is hope. With truth is freedom. So what is truth? So many are searching for truth, and there is an absolute truth we can embrace with confidence. This truth is love, and this truth authors our faith. In 1 John 14:6, Jesus said unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes unto the Father but by me. Later in John, we find that Pilate asked Jesus a question. That's John 18:37. Pilate therefore said unto him, Art thou a king then? Jesus answered, Thou sayest that I'm a king. To this end was I born, and for this cause I came into the world, that I should bear witness unto the truth. Everyone that is of the truth hears my voice. So Jesus is truth, and he bears witness unto the truth, and truth has a voice. Truth. Think about that. What is truth? To so many situations and people, truth can be challenging. Adam and Eve were face to face with truth because the glory of God holds the truth. They also turned away from truth to gain their own truth. Outside of truth is injustice. Outside of truth is hate. Outside of truth is brokenness. Outside of truth is error. And outside of truth is legalism, religion, and failure. Do you realize truth requires sacrifice? We can find now that Jesus made it clear that truth is the sacrifice, and he who is truth holds the foundational covenant, his covenant of truth. The Lord requires us to be of the truth. We are his sheep, and we hear his voice. We hear the voice of truth. You know, truth is defined in Webster's dictionary as the quality or state of being true. That clearly is who Jesus and his word is. It also defines truth as belief. I thought that was really interesting because faith comes by hearing and hearing the word or hearing his truth. And that is how belief is established. You know, we are to be the people that believe. We're to believe the gospel of Jesus Christ and creatively release our gifts for the purpose of living and breathing and bringing the truth. Living is love and promoting is justice. Each of us has a destiny and a destination. And he sends us for a reason. It's the reason of truth, bearing witness of truth. As faith comes by hearing and hearing the word, we're hearing truth. We are to take faith and bring it to the world. And we're to be his witness of his truth. Jesus, again, he said, I am the way. I am the truth. And I am the life. And his word and his teaching is his example of truth. Importantly, our faith is a relief. It's not a risk. When we step out, we finish. Because it's already been finished in him. And that is the truth. That is what holds the strength of truth. Because he is the truth and he has finished it. So truth opens up relief, relief in every situation. Truth opens up relief in the lives of people who hear and obey truth or embrace it. We're to be imitators of God and imitators of truth and imitators of faith. See, you can see yourself as he sees you, and you can see yourself in and by his truth. We are to see ourselves as he sees us. And we are to see ourselves as he does. We're born of truth, we're filled with truth, and we're witnessing truth. We're also expressing truth and living truth as we embrace him. Truth brings the impossible to light, and truth is life. We are who he says we are. We have what he says we have, and we can do what he says we can do because he is speaking truth. And when you look into the mirror of his word, you can see the reflection of who you are because his word is truth. And that truth reflects into you, through you, and it can reflect by you. You are the key. You are special and you are designed and you are purposed. You are blessed and you are creative. And you can run with his vision, the vision of truth, the vision of his word. And truth sets us free. Truth brings that freedom that we can rise upon eagle's wings and we can run and just experience the freedom of God. Because vision and truth run together, and vision runs on faith. And we run by faith, living truth and equipped by truth. As you stick close to truth, you stick to his vision, what you see in his word, what you see in him. As you do, then you're sticking close to him who is truth. Jesus, again, he said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. And truth speaks to his own, and we listen. You know, you can go on a journey and be successful through obedience to truth, meaning embracing truth. And you can let faith grab a hold of your spirit to see the invisible and do the impossible. And you move forward in that journey of truth and embrace his word, and you will find yourself in the impossible every day, living and breathing things that you could not even imagine. It's even more than you can imagine. Truth prospers you. Truth blesses you. You are prospering with a purpose. Working on your own costs you something, but vision brings you something. Truth brings life and produces fruit. Faith is where you are in him, in his word, in his truth, in his vision. Our faith embraces his truth. I want to say that again. Faith is where you are in him. Where you are in his word, where you are in his truth, where you are in his vision. And your faith embraces his truth. Where you are in his truth is life, and it's every promise of God. His truth leads you in each season of your dreams, fulfilling your dreams, living your dreams, and bringing forth that creative life of your dreams, because we belong to the dominion of truth. And we live in the kingdom of truth. Your words can be filled with his truth. His word is truth. What you speak, speaking his truth, speaking his word, it holds the intellect and the heart of his community, community between you and him and his word. And you being able to, through that communion with God, reaching the world by him who is truth and his truth. Daniel 11:32 says, they that know their God will be strong and do great things. They will do great exploits. Knowing him, knowing his truth is knowing him. He reveals himself to you through his word. Your faith grows through the word. Faith, again, I've said, comes by hearing and hearing the word. And the word bears witness of the truth. The witness is found in you. That witness of truth is found in your life. And who you creatively are, his truth is birthing life in you every single day because he has already given it. You know, Esther came for such a time as this. And it says that through Esther and Mordecai's written decree that everyone had a good day, a happy day. These were days of truth, a days with nothing missing or broken in their lives. It says this in Esther 9:30. And he sent letters unto all the Jews to the kingdom with words of peace and truth. We are in his kingdom of truth. This truth is his life. It is his word. It is his blessing. And it says in John 1:15 that it was John who bore witness of the truth. And we can bear witness of the truth just as he did. We bear witness of his truth as we receive his blessing and his word by faith. In 1 Timothy 2:7, it says, whereunto I am ordained a preacher and an apostle. I speak the truth in Christ and lie not. A teacher of the Gentiles in faith. He is speaking life and truth. And this is the truth of Christ. And we don't lie against truth because truth stands forever. It says in John 5:33 that he sent John bearing witness unto the truth. That is who we are. We are sent bearing witness unto the truth. First, Jesus is sent to you to bear witness of the truth in you, to you, for you. And now he is bearing witness of the truth through you. In John 8:32, it says, you shall know the truth and the truth shall make you free. You are free in truth. Freedom, true freedom is found in His truth. And we can live out and bring freedom, and we can stand in the justice of God. We can stand in the goodness of God. We can stand in the love of God because we stand in truth. You know, here's a few points of truth. We can hear truth because truth has a voice. John 18:37 says, we are those who hear, listen, and go after truth. And again, faith comes by hearing, hearing truth. Truth is speaking. His word is speaking. And we are those who pursue truth, those purposed in truth. And we are purposed and we pursue because we hear truth. Another point is truth has no fault. As He is the truth, then truth has no fault in it. His truth has no fault. There's no fault in Him. It says in John 18:38, Pilate said unto Him, what is truth? And when He said this, He went out again unto the Jews, and He said unto them, I find in Him no fault at all. Pilate saw truth. He came right in front of truth, and truth spoke to him. And he asked, what is truth? And he said, I find in Him no fault. There is no fault in truth. And again, His word is truth. And another point is we're sanctified by His truth. As we uphold and pursue His word, we're set apart by His word. We are to set ourselves apart in and through His word. Being sanctified means you are set apart. You are set apart from everything that is contrary to His truth. You are set apart from everything that goes against His truth. He has set you apart because you are set and signed and sealed and delivered in truth. John 17:17 says it this way, sanctify them through thy truth. Thy word is truth. You are set apart in His word. John 17:19 says, and for their sakes, I sanctify myself, that they also might be sanctified through the truth. Jesus set Himself apart that we could be set apart through His truth. You know, that word sanctified is hagiazo. It means to render and to acknowledge. It means to separate from the wrong things and dedicate it to the right things of God. It means to consecrate it to the things of God, the Word of God, the truth of God. It means to purify and to cleanse and to set you free from guilt and to renew. Sanctifying is renewing. And we are renewed in His truth. We are set apart. We are freed from guilt. We are freed from all things that are contrary. We are cleansed and purified, and we are separated from everything again that is contrary through His truth. And Jesus set Himself this same place, set Himself purely as truth that we could be sanctified through it with Him. Another point is the word of faith which we speak is truth, and that sets us apart. In 2 Corinthians 4:13, it says, we having the same spirit of faith, according as it is written, I believed and therefore have I spoken. We also believe and therefore we speak. And as that belief comes forth through speaking, when we speak His word, we are speaking His truth, and it sets us apart from anything outside of His word. All things outside of truth, as we speak and embrace with the same spirit of faith that Jesus had, the God kind of faith, we are separating ourselves in truth. When we embrace His word, we're set apart by His word. When we live by His word, we are set apart in His word. The word of truth which we live, the word of truth which lives through us, we are flooded by His truth, by the power of the Holy Spirit. Another point is truth is not stopped. It says in 2 Corinthians 11:10, as the truth of Christ is in me, no man shall stop me. As you embrace truth, nothing can get in your way. Nothing can stop you. 2 Corinthians 13:8 says, for we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth, because the truth cannot be stopped. Truth lives forever. Truth embraces forever. And truth stands forever. And truth is written forever. And Jesus has sealed, signed, and delivered truth through his sacrifice and by his resurrection. And the blood of Jesus has brought truth fully in our lives so we can embrace and we can speak his word. And as we embrace him, we live the word, we live in him, and we are experiencing truth that cannot be stopped. Everything outside of his word is a truth. Anything outside of his word is not truth. His word is the foundation and is all truth. Believing him at his word, that is where truth remains. Not exchanging it for anything else, but living and giving truth, experiencing truth, embracing truth, and knowing it's God-given truth to you. In 1 Corinthians 13:6, it says, "Rejoice not in iniquity or anything outside of truth, but rejoice in the truth." You know, another point is we find our freedom in truth. John 4:23 says, "But the hour comes and now is when true worshipers shall worship the Father in spirit and in truth. For the Father seeketh such to worship him." That freedom to worship and be embraced by the Spirit of truth in your life brings so much life to you. There is a difference between truth and law. Truth sends you forward, but law keeps you bound. To receive the truth is direction. It's a turnaround. But to deny the truth is bondage. To make truth law is legalism. But to embrace the person of truth is love. See, the key is going forward and breaking free from the past. The Lord's moving you forward. You don't have to be bound by what you failed in or what should have been, because truth sets you free. And as you go every day, you are experiencing something new. The path of the righteous grows brighter and brighter because truth is a lamp unto your feet. It is new because faith is for today, and truth and faith go hand in hand. Faith is now. It is the now life, a truth life, and it is your now freedom. Another point is that speaking truth grows us up in all things. Ephesians 4:15 says that speaking the truth in love so that you may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. As you embrace the truth, as you embrace the word of God, you grow up in more and more revelation and knowing. And that truth is expressed through you. As you speak truth, not everyone accepts it. Galatians 4:16 says, "Amazingly, it is the truth that sets you free, but people can oppose the truth through unbelief." In verse 16, it says this, "Am I therefore become your enemy because I tell you the truth?" Truth can often have a challenge, but you can amazingly experience truth to grow up in all things, to hear the truth. And as the truth bears witness of truth to you, you can grow and be more experienced in truth, because his Spirit is the Spirit of truth. And he sends his Spirit to us so that we can embrace and believe in him. Another point is we are experiencing love and are guided in truth. Love, mercy, promote justice, live truth. John 15:26 says, "But when the Comforter is come, who I will send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceeded from the Father, he shall testify of me." You are guided in truth. You are guided in love. John 16:13 says, "Howbeit when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth. For he shall not speak of himself, but whatsoever he shall hear, that shall he speak, and he will show you things to come." The Spirit of truth is guiding you. He is speaking to you. He is speaking so you will hear truth, and he is showing you things to come. What a beautiful thing that truth is revealing to us blessings to come. By him, we can live truth, not by law, but by love and by faith. It says in 1 Peter 1:22, "Seeing you have purified your souls and obeying the truth," that means embracing the truth through the Spirit, "unto unfeigned love of the brethren." See that you love one another with a pure heart fervently. Truth loves, and it embraces love of others. And in 1 John 3:18, it says we are to love in truth. That's another point. My little children, let us not love in word, neither in tongue, but in deed and in truth. Meaning, move forward in truth and love, not just by, you know, saying something, but by doing something. As we speak the word of God, he wants us to act on his word. In 2 John 1:1, it says, the elder unto the elect lady and her children, that's the church, and those who come in daily, whom I love in truth, and not I only, but also all they that have known the truth. He is saying that truth loves. We love in truth, and we can experience the fullness of faith and love and hope in truth, who is Jesus. So as we move forward, the truth will declare to you that you are chosen. The truth declares to you that you are chosen in truth, that you are chosen in his spirit, that you are chosen in the gospel, and that you are purposed and called to preach the gospel of Jesus, who is truth. And this gospel is the truth we speak. And as I said it before, in 1 Peter 2:9, you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who has called you out of darkness and into his marvelous light. We are to be people of love, promoting justice and his goodness in his marvelous light. You know, another point that is that truth has made us acceptable. We are accepted by truth and in the truth. We are to be living our lives in and by the truth, which is our living sacrifice, acceptable unto God, a reasonable service. Romans 12:1 says, I beseech you therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy, acceptable unto God, which is your reasonable service. Truth has accepted you, and that is your reasonable service to express truth. Truth has embraced you, and your reasonable service is to embrace truth. Remember, he is truth. Embrace him. Accept him. He has accepted and embraced you. And through that truth of being embraced and accepted, you can embrace and accept others by giving them truth, who is Jesus. You know, the truth says that we are creative. This is a very important point. The truth makes it clear that we are created in the image of the Creator, and he's made us creative. We in truth can be truthfully who we are created to be. He's made us free to be as we live by and in his truth. We are free to be who he has created us to be. There's a creative purpose in us. As we embrace by love the truth, as we live in his truth and we embrace him as truth, we are free and creativity flows richly in and through us. We're creative in truth. We're creative by truth. And truth is creative in us. We're creative in that truth. As we accept him and as we accept his word, truth speaks through our creativity. As we move forward, what is your season right now? Where are you? Let there be a creative season in these moments. What's before you? Are you speaking more of his truth, his word, and his blessing? Well, move forward each day creatively. Bring forth all that's in you that he's placed. First, by speaking his word creatively, and move forward in all that he's given you. Be creative and move creatively through every area and opportunity he's giving you right where you are. His truth is creative. His truth has created you. It says in Ephesians 2:10, for we are his workmanship created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God has before ordained that we should walk in them. He has ordained us in his truth. He has blessed us in good works. And we are his creative workmanship through truth. Ephesians 4:24 says that we can put on the new man, which after God is created in righteousness and true holiness. We are created new by truth. Colossians 3:10 says it this way, and have put on the new man, which is renewed in the knowledge after the image of him that created him. We have been renewed in truth. in the revelation of truth, and we see who he is. Jesus asked Peter, "Who do you say that I am?" And Peter answered, "You are the burden-removing, yoke-destroying truth, the Christ." And as Jesus looked at him, he said, "Flesh and blood hasn't revealed this to you, but the Father who is in heaven, because truth is speaking. The Spirit is speaking truth to you." So move forward in the blessing. Move forward in prayer, girded in truth, speaking his word, being creative in his word, and experience his creative move in you and bring your creativity forward. Take this season of prayer and movement. It is the movement of truth, and be creative in this season. Again, you are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people. You should show forth the praises, show forth the creativity, show forth the truth of him who's called you out of darkness into his marvelous light. We're living in the light of truth. Jesus is the light. He is the King of truth. He is the truth. He is Lord. And we are to be embracing the Prince of Peace, who by his truth has given us life, with nothing missing and nothing broken. Truth has been given. It is yours. 1 John 1:17 says, "The law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ." You've been given grace. You've been given the ability to experience truth. His word is truth. His word is a lamp unto your feet. I close with you by Psalm 119, 103 through 107, and 172, and by John 17:17. "How sweet are your words unto my taste, yea, sweeter than honey to my mouth. Through your precepts I get understanding, therefore I hate every false way. Your word is a lamp unto my feet, and a light unto my path. I have sworn, and I will perform it. I will embrace your word," is what this verse means. I will keep your word. I will stand on it. I will not be moved away from your truth. And he goes on to say in 107, "Quicken me, O Lord, according to your word." His word is truth. And he says in verse 172, "My tongue shall speak of your word." Just declare, "I speak your truth. I speak your word. I speak your love. I speak justice. I speak life." Father, I pray that as those who've heard today, that they hear truth. They hear your voice of truth. Holy Spirit, you are the Spirit of truth. Minister to the hearts who have heard truth, the truth of your blessing, the truth of your word, the truth of your abundance, the truth of your life, the truth of who you are, and the truth of your sacrifice, the truth of your blood, the truth of all you've given, and the truth of your resurrection. And I pray as they embrace your truth, that I know your word promises that they will know you, and they will know truth, and that truth shall set them free. And the people that know their God will be strong and do great exploits. And in this season, I declare a movement of truth, a movement of life, a movement of you, bringing them a good day. In Jesus' name, amen.
Pastor Kim is not only a screenwriter, director, and producer, she writes children's books and other publications. If you're interested in more of her Kix Media from Kix Ministries, check out our family faith-based feature films, Pastor Kim's blogs, and our many children's books and publications at kixtv.com.